Praise the Lord. How many of you feel clean? Praise God. I'm sorry, there were a lot of people near me and I couldn't attend to all of them. But I'll tell you something about their confessions. Who came to me? As I sat down there and I listened to each one, I said, how much God must be loving them. My heart went out to each person as they came. And I wanted to hug them and say, my child, you are so hurt. You're so hurt. I felt like just hugging them, each one of them. I said, my child, you're so hurt. So many things have happened in your life. If that was my heart, can you imagine the heart of your father? He was embracing you there and saying, I love you, my child. I love you so much. We have made our God into a terrible God. You know, when a mother is taking a daughter, might be, or a son, and the child, they are going on the footpath and the little child walks down from the footpath and a car is coming, the mother sometimes jumps and holds the car and brings the child to safety. And because she cannot, she's so frightened that the child might have died over there. The mother starts, why did you go down? Why did you go down? She beats the child. Sometimes we think our Father is like that. We think our Father, Heavenly Father, is like that. That when we do wrong, He beats us. No. He feels compassion for us. And Jesus went up onto the mountain and said, let us go and spend time quietly. And while they were going there, people knew where they were going and they came in a huge crowd. Orle lokailo soglo and Jesu vetalo. Talk. He had become tired. The others were tired and they were going to rest. And there was lok urupunji so lok urupunji aili. And Jesus takam poile ani munuk nare baba yakita kailat. Jesus, the scripture says, and he looked at them and had compassion on them. Compassion mullar kude. Tacha kali is sarkens kele. Compassion words, the word comes from a imagery. When a mother is carrying a child in a womb, sometimes the mother does like this on a womb. This is not a womb, by the way. This is natural. Women become fat for 9 months and they are okay. I'm carrying this for quite a long time. But the mother puts her hand round and she wishes the very best for the child. I hope my child comes out well. I hope my child has all the ten fingers and 10 toes. I wish my child doesn't have any defects. I wish my child becomes the best child in the world. That's her wish. That is compassion. And the Lord saw them, had compassion on them. And he told them, he had compassion because they were harassed and dejected. And he said, the harvest is plentiful, but the workmen are few. pray to the Lord of the harvest that he might send more laborers into his vineyard, into his harvest. His heart went out to them. And to those who came to me, and I'm sure to the other of us, our hearts went out to you because we are the laborers he called for. But imagine what must be the heart of the Father. Just wanting to hold you and say, my baby, my son, it's okay, I love you. It's not like our human father, human mother, because of her own nervousness, beats the child. Can you imagine you fall down and God comes and says, you fell down? Can you imagine your father doing that? Sin is falling down. And the Lord, when he sees you fallen down, he picks you up and says, my Baba. And holds you and he says, son, are you hurt? Did it hurt you? Daughter, did it hurt you? And so what I was telling you earlier, I'm telling you now, what will the priest think about me? He thinks you are beautiful. I didn't look at the beauty of the face, so I'm not saying about that. But you are beautiful inside. You have hurt. Something has happened wrong because of others or because of you. And the Lord only says, come, Baba, I'll lift you up. And I hope that is what you feel, a joy that your father has not stamped on you, but the father has lifted you and held you and said, come back, my child. Oh, I've forgotten. Thank you for telling me. Please remind me, okay? Because I get carried away in one language. Kal maka sangle tu chod kokni ulaita. So my gear went from 1 to 5. And I have to come back to 3. But how many देव जेन्ना आमी पातकांत पडटात आमी खाला पडलेल्या भाशेन मनशां देव येवन आमकां आनीक मारिना तूं पडलो खाला पडलो तूं खाला पडलें कित्याक पडलें कित्याक पडलें देव तशें म्हणिना देव आमकां उबारता आमकां आपल्या हालक्यान घालता आनी म्हणटा म्हज्या पुता म्हज्या दुये दूख लागली तुका कितें लागलें तुका आनी परतो तो आमचो मोग करता नेवर बी अफ्रेड टू गो टू योर गॉड द डिफरन्स बिट्वीन एडम एंड डेविड वॉज दिस When Adam sinned, God did not reject him. Jadna Adavan kam patok kele, tenna devan tachi beporba korugna. Adavan patok kele. Pun dusre disak, sodanche bashin, amka povitra pustok munda. Dusre disak, sodanche bashin, dev porto ailo. आनी देवान म्हणलें आदाम खंय तूं आसा वेर आर यू गॉड डीड नॉट टर्न फ्रॉम मॅन ही केम बॅक हू हॅड टर्न्ड मॅन देवान म्हणलें आदाम तूं खंय आसा आनी ताणें म्हणलें हांव लिपलो कित्याक हांव नागडो विगडो आसा हांव नागडो आसा विगडो आसा म्हूण आनी देव ताका एक सहयोग दिता तुवें हांवें सांगलेलें तें फळ खाल्लें कितें देवाक खबर नासली नो माय मदर वॉज लायक गॉड There was a cucumber, small cucumber. My mother was stricter than, you know, anybody else in the world. There was a small cucumber, and I loved cucumber. And now I eat cucumber because my mother is not there to paste me. So one day I saw this cucumber, laar padung lagli, went, looked this side, that side, and I ate that cucumber. My mother must have seen. Sanjay vicharle, vadle lagi, tu ek toshe asle nahi, khui gele te, vadlan mulle, maka khabar na, dusryan mulle, maka khabar na, bahinin mulle, tis chotyan mulle, ame panch jana, majhe lagi vicharle, tu ek khala ke tere, na mama, ai khau na. काऊक ना अरे ताचा फाटल्यान हे गेले काबार काऊक ना पण तिने म्हाका सुयोग दिल्लो तुवें खाल्लां कितें रे हांवें सांगलेलें जाल्यार वय मामा हांवें खाल्लें ती म्हाका दाटा येता आसली पूण म्हाका सोडून दिता आसली गॉड कम्स द सेकेंड डे एन्ड सेड Did you eat of the fruit that I have eaten, that I have told you not to eat? If at that time Adam had said, Yes, Lord, I ate, you and I would have not suffered. That fellow was given a second chance. Our God is a God of chances. He asked him, did you eat of this fruit? If he had said, yes, Lord, I did it, the Lord would have embraced him. But he says, you must be mad, Lord, to think I have done it. I am your highest creation. How can you think that I can do it? That woman whom you gave to me, I didn't ask. हांवें सांगूंक ना म्हाका बायल जाय म्हण तुवें दिल्या ते बायलेन म्हाका नाडलो देखून हांवें खालें एंड गॉड गिव्स हर ए चान्स शी कूड हॅव डिलिवर्ड विच आवर ब्लेसड मदर हॅड टू डू शी कूड हॅव डिलिवर्ड द ह्यूमन रेस वेन गॉड आस्क्ड हर एंड ईव वॉट डीड यू डू शी शूड हॅव सेड येस लॉर्ड आय एम सॉरी आय डीड इट I got tempted, and the Lord would have embraced her and said, okay. But she said, I'm a better version of Adam. You did a mistake there, so you made me. You think I would have done this? The serpent did it. God comes to us back. Even when we do wrong, he comes to us back. So when Adam sinned, he went away from the Lord. On the other hand, when David sinned, he said, Let me go before the Lord, for I have sinned. You see the difference? One says, and this is what we usually do, those of you who were making your confession, you'll remember. You will say, I have sinned, Baba, I am osana, Igo jinkosana, kuminyangi una, ani kain karina, ame patok kela. We run away from God. That's our normal tendency. Ame patok kela. No, I don't want to say my prayers. I don't want to read the Bible today. I have sinned. I don't want to do this. Think about it, what I am saying. The right thing to do is that Adam said, I have sinned, I cannot go before the presence of the Lord. David said, I have sinned, I need to go before the face of the Lord and ask his forgiveness. Okay, that's our God. A God who is just waiting for us to come. Okay, and this is what has happened. And today I hope all of you have opened your heart and said, Lord, this is what I am. I only told you this because you say, what will the priest think about you? The priest think you're beautiful. You're a hurt person. Others have done wrong to you. You have done wrong. And that hurt is there within you. I'm telling you, I feel like embracing anybody who comes and opens their heart. Imagine a million times more is your Heavenly Father just waiting to come into His embrace. Okay, my dear brothers and sisters, we have talked about this, and I hope most of you and the others will use this occasion. I have also promised that in between the talks, etc., I'll still sit down for confession if you want to go. I don't know if the other priests will be available. Anybody, please open your heart. Take away every cockroach that is there, even if it's a little fellow. He doesn't belong there. Okay? Open your heart. And open your heart for what? Jesus said, when you drive away, when an evil spirit goes away from a man, to a baisoron veta terna, udas nato, konkani no long. To bairik, mero otmo, asa to bair kele operant, taka zago merona. आणि तो पळयता आणि परतो येऊन पळयता तुझ्यान काळीज तर साप तुवें केल्ले आसा जाल्यार आनी कांय तुवें ना जाल्यार तो येवन थंय बसता आनी सात आनीक ताच्याहून फास्ट देवसारां काडून भितर घेता. सो दॅट प्लेस इज नॉट मेड. सम ऑफ यू वेमेन वील नो दीस. तुमच्या घरांत कुजनांत आयदोणां आसात न्ही, आनी त्या वखदार एक नुस्तें घेवन येता. नुस्तें 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 म्हण. अरे कितल्यान दिला रे? अरे 100 रुपयांक कितें 10 बांगडे. हां 10 बांगडे गोंयचे मरे, फर्मिनाचे न्ही म्हूण गोंयचेच. सो दाय म्हणटा बरें बरें राव 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 राव. भितर वेता आयदोणां पळयतात. सगळीं आयदनां भरलेलीं आसात. एक आयदन इज एम्प्टी, वन इज एम्प्टी. सो यू डोंट थिंक एट दॅट टायम, यू रिक्वायर टू गेट इट. सो यू टेक दॅट एम्प्टी अँड पुट द फिश देर. तेंगुडे तुवें दवरले जाल्यार कित्याक? फॉर सम स्पेशल थिंग. दुदूच घालतालें तूं आनी कांयच घालिनासलें पयलें, पूण आतां तिंता निस्तें आयलें, फॉर्मीन नासलेलें निस्तें. ओके? सो वेन अ थिंग इज एम्प्टी वी नो दीस. नो वी आर लुकींग आवट. इट हॅज हॅपन टू ऑल ऑफ अस इन्क्लुडींग मी. यू आर लुकींग आवट टू पूट समथींग. यू लुक आवट फॉर समथींग. समटायम्स यू हॅव टू इवन गो टू एग्जामिन अ युरीन. यू हॅव टू फायंड आवट अ बॉटल. वन बॉटल इज देअर, यू टेक अँड गो. What is empty? And the Lord says, if you have emptied your heart, which we have done today, if you keep it empty like that, again He comes and you will become worse than before. You have to fill it. And that is what we are going to do. And the first thing I want to talk to you is, fill it with holiness. Holy Spirit, I will say, but fill it with holiness. All of us have to be holy, otherwise we should walk out from this place. When God called the people of Israel, He said, you must be holy as I, your Lord, am holy. Tumi bhagyun taung jai aun asa te bhashin. तुम्ही पवित्र जाऊंक जाय हांव आसा ते भाशेन. दॅट वॉज द फर्स्ट कॉल टू द पीपल ऑफ इज्रायल. वेन ही टूक देम आउट ऑफ इजिप्ट, ही सेड देम, यू हॅव टू बी होली इफ यू वॉन्ट टू बिलोंग टू मी. तुम्ही मुझ्या भाशेन पवित्र जाऊंक जाय. अँड दिस इज अ कॉल फॉर एवरी वन ऑफ अस. यू कांट बी अ क्रिश्चियन and not be holy. We all of us wonder what is behind our name. When I go preaching, priests And when I'm introduced, they'll say, before I'm introduced, Father, what degree do you have? Where did you do your PhD? Where did you do your doctorate? Where did you do this? We're all worried what is behind the name. God is worried about what is before your name. S.T. Saint. Are you a saint? Are you walking towards sainthood? Tum bhagyon zala, tum povit zala. Ek disuka bhagyont tuja naam mantelet. We are standing in a place which was hallowed by one of our own brothers, Goenkaran. O povitra zago zaonasa. Anga ek povitra munis ra jelolo. Zaiti aslet pun ek pun amizanao. Bagyon zevas. To me, Goenkar zaonasa tajabashin. Ami tachabashin povitra zaonsai. The call is to everyone. The last three popes have been, the last four popes really, have been telling us, holiness is not a privilege. Sainthood is not a privilege of a few, but the duty and responsibility of every Christian. Sant bhagyon saung, todankus devan vinsud kanukna, sogle kristavani, Bhagyot Zaung Zai. And our new Pope, Pope Francis, says things in a different way. He says, do not be shy to be saints. Lajanagat. Bhagyot Zaung. Don't be shy to be a saint. That's your duty. That's your job. And now that you have opened your heart and cleared away all the cockroaches and the dirt that was there, fill it with holiness. Today we have to make a decision. I am going to be holy as you, my Father, as is holy. For you are holy. That's our job. That's why we were created. That's what we have to be for all eternity. Holiness is not for a few people, and especially for you and us who are leaders in the church. If we are not holy, who will be holy? Saint Peter stresses this in his letter. Again, taking up what was said that time, 1 Peter 1:15, 16. As he who called you is holy, be holy yourself in all your conduct. Since it is written, you shall be holy, for I am holy. In all your conduct. Not holiness only when you go to the church. Igorjin gele uprant. Deva saiba bogo shani hai koi raza kele bahar gate re are tu kon re. Start giving bad words. I've seen this so often. In the church, holy as you can be. Once you're outside the church, tonatle aneta sarge one stream of bad words. That's not the holiness. In all your conduct, in everything that you do. Now, what is holiness? Holiness is to be set aside. You are consecrated to God. The day you were born, you were baptized, you were marked. Makatane? Abhishek kela toka abhishek kello bhagyon zaung povitra zaung. You were consecrated. You might have seen church being consecrated. The bishop comes, bishop eta rozar korta povitra telan te makta. आणि मागीर पाद्री जावं बिशप वसून सगळे जाग्यार तो मागता होल थिंग दॅट बिकम्स कॉन्सक्रेटेड टू गॉड. आनी एक गोज केल्या उपरांत ती आमी पोरक्या कामांक वापरनात. यू डोंट मेक इट इन टू अ बार. सम ऑफ आवर चर्चीस हॅव बिकम बार्स बट दे हॅव बीन डी desecrated or they have been taken off from being in the holy list. But when it is holy, it is not to be used for profane things. Parkya kamant ami te vaprung jaina. Ami igorjo nosun white vastu kochonant kitak ti povyo to povit zago zauna sa. And so are you set aside, consecrated to God. Paul will tell us, do you not know that you are the temple of the Holy Spirit and the Spirit of God resides within you? 1 Corinthians 3, 1 Corinthians 6. You are the temple of God. Deo tujha vitora sa. That's why a church is holy, it is consecrated. We are using a chalice on during the mass. Ami anga kals vapurtat. Te kalsind ami osun sarapiyan an magir. Anik povit pustakan tamka dakoita ki jadna te devak devak betoilele vostu vapurtat tedna tanka white zata. Consecrated things cannot be used for profane things. The chalice will only be used, or will destroy it if it is spoiled, but will not be used for profane things. You cannot be used for profane things because you too are consecrated. Tukai devan maklele asa. Devan tuka ek kerit bashin dusriya लोकांतली भायर काढल्या आणि आपल्याक आपणायल्या. मेड यू इन टू हिज ओन. सो यू आर कॉल्ड टू बी होली जस्ट एज द लॉर्ड इज होली. वी कॅनॉट रीच दॅट बट दॅट इज आवर मॉडल. द फादर, द सन, द होली स्पिरिट आर आवर मॉडल्स. अँड दिस वुमन lived a life of holiness. That's why we call her Holy Mary, Mother of God. That is what you and I are called to be holy as our Father is holy. Paul, in fact, refers to his Christians as saints. To the saints of Corinth, to the saint of this and to the saint of that. Can we say the same of us? To the saints of Goa, to the saints of Kartali, to the saints of... Can you be called that way? A saint is someone who is consecrated, who is holy, who lives the life of God that God has given us. That's going to be our model from the day today. To be holy. There was a little boy, it seems, sitting, kneeling with his mother and saying, Lord, keep me holy. And the mother nudged him and said, son, not keep me holy, make me holy. You cannot say, I have reached the top of holiness. I'm sure Mother Teresa, as she was dying, said, Lord, I could have done so much more. Right? Right?
Yes.
Nidle musta.
Praise the Lord!
Praise the Lord!
Man,
it's easy to bring charismatic back to life. Just say praise the Lord. We have never reached... Holiness is a journey, not a destination. Holiness is a journey. Povitr porn, ami ketnats, aum povitr oshe morung zain amka sadans, anikui zago asa, anikui fudiam chan osung zata. We can keep on doing. No saint would have said, I have done it, it is over. They say, I could have still done more. Even Paul, who said, I've run the race, I've finished the fight, also said, I don't know whether I should be with God or I should be with you, because there is so much more that is there for me to do. But tor ai san tumi tor khorens fudari zalar ai san tumi murung sai saiba aum bhagyon zatlo aum povit zatlo. My body, I'm going to be make very, very holy. I remember once, very, very beginning, I gave this passage of St. Paul. Do you not know that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit and that the Spirit of God resides in you? Tuka tu nokoi ki tuja tu povitratmyanche mondir zauna sa ani povitratmo tuja pitora sa mon tuka khobarna. And I said this, and at that moment the Holy Spirit convicted a young man, and he began to sob, and he stood up. Whole group was there. He began to sob and he stood up and he was looking at his hands and says, is this the temple of God? Is this the temple of God? Is God within me? What have I done with this temple? What have I done with it? He started crying there. And there was a mundir zauna sa. Povitratmo ya mundiran trauta. And ya mundira kamen kiten kela. I know that person till today. That day he opened his heart to God. He came for confession and he opened his heart to God. Not that he has not fallen into sin, but till today, that boy, now a man, a holy man. He spends lots of time in prayer. He's so generous to people. He's so good, loving. His own mother came and told me, Father, what did you do with my son? Tue mujhe puta kiten kele? To garant itlo white aslo, zogottalo, martalo, kiten potte potte nitalo. Ata sarkos dusro jala. Tue taka kiten kele? What did you do? I said, I did nothing. He did. His whole life changed. He became a different person altogether. This is the chance God is giving each one of us. We can't be the same again. Otherwise, you're wasting your time and mine. We are becoming different from today. Right? We will fall. Christian life is never a straight line. As a young priest, as a young seminarian, I used to fight against this. Lord, one day I'm so happy with you. I can pray so well. I can be so close to you. And another day everything was fat. Why is this happening? And then one day God revealed to me, Christian life is not a straight line. Christian life goes in circles. One day we are up, one day we might be not up. But what we have to do is look back and say, have I climbed a little? If you judge from day to day, you'll be very disappointed, which as I was. But then I look back and I say, am I a better person, more loving person, a holier person than I was 1 year back, 2 years back? Okay? So that is how our movement is. We go on and we never end. We become holier and holier. We move on to greater holiness. And that is very, very important because, as of course, this we can talk about this. Hebrews 12:14 says, without holiness, we no one will see the Lord. And I don't talk about only the final. Even today you cannot. If you are playing in double game, your one leg is in holiness and one leg is in doing whatever else you want to do, you will not see the beauty of God here today. So you don't have to wait till you die. Morot pasudaupachi gorozna atta tuntor povit zaungna zalar. Ek dis bore jivit jeta, dusre vizet polzol jivita, jivit jeta, white kota, gadio mata, yankota, atam pasunduka deo disti portsona. Without holiness, you cannot see the beauty of God. But if you march in holiness, become a little more holy day by day, you will realize how beautiful it is. Taste and see how good the Lord is. And this is what we are going. This is our call. You were created for this. You were created to be holy. Be holy as I am holy. That's our call. To dusre jaiten korit, jaite vastu tu korit, pon tuen tor e povitrtae tuja jivitan tadukna zalyar. Tuen tor povitru rostyavair solunk shinkukna zalyar ani disandis tu mukar vachona zalyar. Then all your other things are useless. There are many people who are doing greater works than you who don't even believe in God. Now, yeh korta, teh korta, mon sangchi goroz na. Kya tu jaun, jai to lok tu jaun subes korta. Many people, social workers, etc., are doing, giving their life. There are philanthropists who are doing much greater thing. Ours is not philanthropy. Ours is not social uplifting. Ours is loving God, and because of Him, even the little that we do has tremendous value. Believe me? Yes? Sure? Okay. And are you ready to walk on the path to holiness? Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes.
It must be a beautiful yes. And that a yes is what is important. That's where our mother taught us to say yes to the will of God. To do the will of God is to be holy. And she said, I don't care where you take me. But if it is your word, I say yes. Let it be done to me according to your word. Tuye sangla te bashin aun korung tayarasa. Tukatur zai, aun kitens korum tayarasan. That is holiness. And she taught her son so beautifully. The son heard it from her, saw his mother living that, so that one day he repeated her words in his own words. When the cross was before him, and when he had umpteen times to run away, we'll talk about him a little later. He said, not my will, but your thy will be done. Muzo muji koshi noi pun tuka zai te bashin tuji koshi zao. Those are the same words of Mary. Sometimes we don't know. She said, let your will be done. Let me be according to your word. The same words in a different way, his own way, he said. Not my will, but your will be done. So, my dear brothers and sisters, holiness is our call. And the time to be holy is now. Sometimes we make this aum long atan september ni utubrant festa sa e much moza korung jae e korung jae november che poile san aum chalu kortolo november che poile san mullave chalu kortolo khuinche oroste sangugna might be 2025 if you don't do it today you won't do it. This is the moment of grace. Now is the time of grace. Atta korin andalar tum ke dance korchona. Atta tuve yusuk nazalar ais tuve mulog nazalar saiba ais ame sukni patkan tu jatan dilant. Ane au mujhe jivit tu ka petoita. Tu ka zaite bashe naun kortolo. I will do only your will. I stoon tosha mudin and the latum catdans murchina. Atle soyo getle potte. Punte atelet mun rauchane. Opportunity, they say, is like a man who is bald all over and has got only hair here. Thode pauti asat muncha dusline. Angas tangan kens asat yodan kain kensna. तो मनीस तुझ्या मुखार येता तेदना तूं तो रागना ताका दोरिना जाल्यार फाटल्यान मागीर दवरूंक मेळना येता तेदना ताका तुवें दवरूंक जाय आयज तो आयला तुमच्या मुखार टुडे द ऑपॉर्च्युनिटी हॅज कम ही इज वॉकिंग बिफोर यू कॅच हिम नाव ऑर यू विल नेवर गेट हिम अगेन. Got it? Huh? Eyes. Today is the day of salvation. I have seen lives changed on this day when people open their heart to God. And they have never been the same again. I told you about this boy and I have umpteen examples of people who at this time were touched by God when they said, Lord, it's over for me. No more sin, no more life like this. I want to be yours. Not that they didn't fall in sin. I fall into sin and I need God's forgiveness. But the choice, the fundamental choice is made for God. On this day, I stand, aum, veglot zatlo, dusrot zatlo. From today, I'll become a different person. We'll talk a little more of how to be holy. What are the steps for us, especially as charismatics, to be holy? But this is one thing that is important. The greatest desire of our lives should be to be holy. The only thing I want to do is be holy. Everything else is that. I tell people, one of the things in holiness is to pray. Father, I can't pray. I can't spend 10 minutes with Jesus. I said, then you pray that you go to hell. Huh? What, Father? Pray that you go to hell. Why, Father? Because if you can't spend 10 minutes with him now, how are you going to spend an eternity with him? Day after day, minute after minute, hour after hour, year after year, 1,000 years after 1,000 years, you are supposed to live for eternity with him. And if I can't spend 10 minutes, 15 minutes a day to day with him, तूं आनी सोऱ्यार कित्याक वयता रे बाबा हिंगा तुज्यान 10 मिनटो जेजू बराबर सारूंक जायना जाल्यार तूं सासनाचें सासन ताच्या सांगता कसो सारतलो देवचरा बरेक वच तुंय मेवतलें तुका जेजू वचपाचीच गरज ना. अंडरस्टँड दिस व्हॉट आय एम सेइंग या वी हॅव टू लर्न टू फॉल इन लव विथ हिम अँड देन वन डे ही कम्स देर इज नो प्रेयर. You have been so close to him, you walk with him. And there I met so many people. I met so many people who are like this. Last year, 2 years back, we lost one priest, old man. But he was so much with God. He told me, Fernando, let me go now. I want to go. Let me go. All my life, I wanted to be with him. Let me go. Because we were giving him things and all. He wanted to go. I met a woman, a lady, dying in the hospital, cancer, totally gone, in deep pain. And I went to see her and she said, Father, you know, I'm lying down there here, I know I'm dying. It's all pain all over. But I'm thanking God. Thanking God for all that he has done. My husband was not a good man. He troubled me, hammered me, did a lot of things. But he was my husband, and God gave him to me. And I thank for my children, and I thank for this and I this. And now I'm counting the days when I'll be with him. With whom? With God, with Jesus. I mean, this is one priest went, it seems, and told the people, how many of you want to go to heaven? Put your hands up. Let's see. How many of you want to go to heaven? Put your hands up. Don't want to go to heaven? How many of you want to go to heaven? Put your hands up. Okay, put up. How many of you want to go to heaven now? Put your hands up. The desire is for heaven, but Lord, not now. Very often. When the time comes, when the day comes, just to walk with him and go. That will only happen, no fright, nothing, just to go. That's a grace from God. But that's also you and I living a life of God and saying, Lord, take me. I'm okay. I'm coming with you. It has to happen one day. There are two ways of going. One is being pushed and the other thing, anyway, I have to go. Somebody tells you, you're making noise over here. There are two ways you can be pushed out from here. One is, and you are saying, no, I'm not going. The other one, okay, I'm going. Let me go. Same thing. One day we all have to go. I tell jokes, huh? Sometimes it is, one priest told him, wanted to make a nice impression on the people. I'm a little light today because I know you all are heavy with all whatever has happened. It's something that happens in our life. You have opened your heart. And sometimes you also have a little kind of this thing, what I did, what will priest might think, what has happened, all those kind of things. This thing, so I'm being a little light with you. So one day the priest said, it seems, my dear parishioners, I guarantee you one thing, every one of you will die. Dramatically he wanted to say, my dear parishioners, I guarantee you one thing, every one of you will die. And one fellow from there started started laughing. He looked at him. Yes, I'm saying to all of you, my parishioners, one day all of you will die. He said, he started laughing there. So the priest said, why are you laughing? He says, I'm not a parishioner. Sumdali mage, aao ye gurjito ni, tumi morat baba, aao dusro. All of us are going to die. There are two ways of dying. All of us are going to die. There are two ways of dying. One, happily, I'm going to my Father's house. This Father I have loved so much. This Jesus I have believed in so much. This Holy Spirit I have lived with so much. I have longed for him. Now I want to go home. I want to go home. So those who are close to the Lord will walk into paradise. There's nothing to fear. There's nothing to fear. And I can tell you this, God's grace it was for me. I was found with tumor in my ear. I hear a little less in this year than this year, so don't come to this year only. But I can hear. Thode pauti bhai, amchi ek sister asli. The sister is again on bostale makai ko ke na man. Dusri sister mina father, padung jay tuka, ti kai ko ke na dalar, tinga sande, ti jana now change korea. Josephine modia jay. Then talk to that sister, father, you know, yesterday sister Josephine, slowly, you know, Josephine, what are you talking about me? Na dusri aay ko ke na pun, teacher now kalle dalar, what you are saying about me? I had this operation. I had a tumor in my ear. I was in Germany for 5 years. And I was telling the doctors, it's paining me inside. And they said, no, it's all psychological. Nothing is wrong with you. But it was paining me so terribly. I went to the doctor over and over again. One day, to cut the story short, he saw the tumor inside. He said, it is hiding behind the drum. And then I was sent to 4 different places. Sometimes we curse India. Listen to this. I was sent to 4 different places, 4 different doctors. They're specialists in this. And they said, it has gone into your brain. You will not survive. You will not survive. It is already gone, spread out into the brain. Your days are numbered. After that, I said, I'm going down to India. I want to wish everybody. I'll come back to die here. Don't worry. I want to be in harness when I die. I'm mortal muntani sangle. But I'm only I'm going to India. Kweta maja lokak mehota and porto eta anga morum. Makanga cancer, tumorous cancer was there inside. A cancerous tumor was there inside. Anyway, I came to go. They said, no, you cannot go because when you're going in the plane, it might burst and die there. You will die there only. I said, whether I die here, I die in a plane, or die, I'll die anywhere, no? So let me go. Anyway, I came here, and to cut the story short, one of my brother priests knew a doctor, took me to the doctor, and the doctor said, Father, I think I can take it out. And he sucked it out, and now many years are over. He told me every 6 months I have to come, and now 6 years are over, I have not gone to him. I think I need to go. But anyway, I'm surviving. I went back and I told them, praise God.
Praise God.
Praise God. I give that credit to God because I prayed, Lord, if it's your will, let you take me. But what surprised me is this. Much later, I realized I was going to die. Much later, I realized I was going to die. They had already pronounced sentence on me. And the greatest gift God gave me is this. I didn't feel scared. I didn't feel scared. People say when they are going to die, when they hear they are going to die, they feel so scared. I didn't feel scared at all. It's after almost a year, suddenly I said, my God, I was going to die. And I didn't even feel scared. We have to give a clap to the Lord for this. And I said, Lord, that's what it should be. I'm coming home. I'm coming home. Why should I be scared? Holiness is that, my dear brothers and sisters. I'm not saying I'm holy, but I have jumped into the arms of my Father and I'm ready to go. I remember when I was in Germany, every plane that passed, I say, when am I going home? When am I going to home? Why am I not in that plane? I long to go home. And if God is our Father, and if that is our home, and if there is all, everybody there, my father, my mother, my brother, my other people whom I loved, if I am there, and I am going home, why should I resist? Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, let's be happy to go home. Let's be happy to die. That comes when you are holy. I'm not saying I'm holy, but what has happened is this. I believe strongly that God is my Father. I've jumped into His arms. In spite of my dirtiness, I know He loves me. And He'll embrace me for all eternity. Tonight it might be we should think about that. Am I afraid of death? So many Christians are paralyzed with the idea of death. I'm sure there are many among you. One day I was going on the road. And one lady started saying, Father, Father, Father. Usually don't hear that in Pune. One fellow here, one fellow there. Here you will find here Father everywhere because so many Christians. I heard that, I stopped. Father, I never thanked you. I said, for what? Father, one day you preached about, for a funeral. You preach about going home. I give them a story about going home. It's going home to the loved ones that we are. In this world we have so many troubles. We are like a broken down car. Everything is not working, tires are not working properly, this is happening, that lights are not working, punctured on the road, and we are putting all this, and one day finally you reach home, and you put off the motor, put off the light, close down the engine, and you walk into the family where your loved ones are waiting for you. Death is that. In this world, we have all troubles, but one day we put off the light and we close down the engine and we walk into the arms of those who are there. And she told me, Father, I was so scared of death, she says. But to tell you the fact, now I'm waiting to die. I'm waiting to die. And my whole life has changed, she says. I believe that God is my Father, which I never did before. I believe God is my Father, and He's just waiting there with His arms open for His child to come to Him. And because of that, her life has changed. She's become what? Holy. She's become holy. And so today, my dear brothers and sisters, you and I have to be in heaven. There's no reason for any one of us not to be there. And if there is, drop it today. Drop it today. We have to go to our home. Our Father, our Lord Jesus, who gave His life for us, the Holy Spirit who is working day and night within us to sanctify us, make us holy, is waiting for us to embrace us for all eternity. You and I cannot miss the bus. We have to be in heaven. And to be in heaven and to be holy, we can give up anything else in this world. 80 years, 90 years, 100 years, I don't think any one of you is going to cross 100. Now, none of you look so strong. 100 years to sacrifice for millions and millions of years Not a great thing. It's not a great thing. If we have to sacrifice a few things in this world, let us sacrifice them happily, because our goal is heaven. And so from today, all of us make once again, I'm not saying that you have never tried this, but once again with our sins forgiven, let us say, I will be holy. I want to be holy, holy, even as my Lord is holy. I want to be holy, holy, even as my Lord is holy. Let's stand. Let's really desire this deep in our hearts. I want to be holy, holy, even as my Lord is holy. I want to be holy, holy, even as my Lord is holy. Lord, please make me holy even as you are holy. Lord, please make me holy, holy, even as you, Lord, are holy. Lord, please make me holy, holy, even as you.